हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आई के सर केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस। हेयर वी आर इन लेक्चर नंबर 10 ऑन रिडॉक्स रिएक्शंस। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द बैलेंसिंग ऑफ रिडॉक्स रिएक्शंस बाय ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर मेथड। द ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर मेथड इज स्पेशली यूजफुल to balance redox reactions given in the molecular form such as HNO3 reacts with I2 producing NO2 and HIO3, that is iodic acid. It is a redox reaction given in the molecular form, and in order to balance such redox reactions, the oxidation number method is more useful than the ion electron method. This method, that is the oxidation number method, consists of following steps. In the first step of oxidation number method, the elements undergoing change in oxidation number are identified, and then these elements are balanced. This first step consists of 4 sub-steps: identify, pair, balance, and change. These 4 sub-steps are applied in the same sequence as given here. And in order to memorize these 4 sub-steps in the same sequence, we use the theory of memory by association, which is also called memory by coding and decoding method. The first letters of these 4 sub-steps are written here, and when to write down these terms, we decode. I means identify, P pair, B means balance, and C means change. It is called memory by coding and decoding method, IPBC. These 4 sub-steps are applied in this sequence. First of all, the elements undergoing change in oxidation number are identified and paired up. Then these elements which undergo change in oxidation number are balanced. Not all the elements are balanced, only those elements are balanced which undergo change in oxidation number during the reaction. And in the final sub-step, the change in oxidation number for each pair is determined. The increase in oxidation number is made equal to decrease in oxidation number in the second step of oxidation number method. Please recall that in the ion electron method, the number of electrons lost in oxidation half reaction is made equal to the number of electrons gained in the reduction half reaction. But in the oxidation number method, the increase in oxidation number is made equal to the decrease in oxidation number. And in the third and final step, the rest elements are balanced as usual, as discussed in the ion electron method, and these have been summarized below. First of all, the reaction is balanced with respect to all the elements except oxygen and hydrogen. Then the reaction is balanced with respect to oxygen by adding H2O molecules to the oxygen deficient side. And thereafter, the reaction is balanced with respect to hydrogen. In the basic medium, H2O molecules are added to the hydrogen deficient side, and the same number of OH minus ions are added to the opposite side in order to balance hydrogen. But in the acidic medium, H plus ions are added to the hydrogen deficient side. Let us compare ion electron method and oxidation number method. The ion electron method consists of resolving the redox reaction into OHR and RHR. The redox reaction is resolved into oxidation half reaction and reduction half reaction, but this step is not required in the oxidation number method. Each half reaction is balanced with respect to charge. It is the most difficult task in the ion electron method, but this step is again not required in oxidation number method because the charge is balanced automatically. And at the end of ion electron method, two half reactions are added. And this step is also not required in the oxidation number method because we have not resolved the redox reaction into OHR and RHR. Thus, all these three steps used in the ion electron methods are not required in the oxidation number method. And therefore, we can say that the oxidation number method is easier than ion electron method. Let us illustrate the oxidation number method of balancing redox reactions with the following reaction, which was discussed earlier. HNO3 reacts with iodine producing NO2 and HIO3. We have to balance this redox reaction by oxidation number method. Let us apply the first step, which consists of four sub-steps. Identify the elements undergoing change in oxidation number are identified. The oxidation number of nitrogen decreases from +5 to +4. And the oxidation number of iodine increases from 0 to +5. Thus, we have identified the elements undergoing change in oxidation number, and then these elements are paired up. HNO3 is paired up with NO2 and I2 is paired up with HIO3. We have paired up the elements undergoing change in oxidation number. Now, the elements undergoing change in oxidation number are balanced. One atom of nitrogen is present on the left hand side and same number of atom of nitrogen is present on the right hand side, and hence nitrogen is balanced. The other element undergoing change in oxidation number is iodine, whose two atoms are present on the left hand side, but only one atom is present on the right hand side, and therefore, in order to balance iodine, we must multiply HIO3 by 2. Thus, we have balanced the elements undergoing change in oxidation number. And finally, in the end of first step, the change in oxidation number is determined for both the pairs. In this pair, the oxidation number change is -1. How this change in oxidation number is calculated? Final oxidation state minus initial oxidation state is equal to the change in oxidation number, and it can be calculated as follows. +4 minus +5, and it is equal to -1. The oxidation number of nitrogen changes by -1, or we can say that the oxidation number of nitrogen decreases by 1. On the other hand, the oxidation number of iodine changes by +10. How it can be calculated? The change in oxidation number is calculated by subtracting the initial oxidation state from the final, final minus initial. The final is +5 minus initial oxidation state is 0, and it is equal to +5. Then why it is multiplied by 2? Because there are two atoms of iodine. and therefore the overall change in oxidation number is plus 10. Thus, we have completed the first step of oxidation number method. Now, let us proceed to step number 2, in which the increase in oxidation number is made equal to decrease in oxidation number. The oxidation number increases by 10, but it decreases by 1, and hence this must be multiplied by 10. Now, the change in oxidation number here is minus 10, and here the change in oxidation number is equal to plus 10. It means the increase in oxidation number is equal to 10, and the decrease in oxidation number is also equal to 10, and thus we have made the increase in oxidation number equal to decrease in oxidation number, but only multiplying minus 1 by 10 is not sufficient. Both the species connected by this arrow are multiplied by 10. Here 10, and it is also multiplied by 10. Thus, we have completed step number 2. Now, let us proceed to step number 3, in which the reaction is balanced with respect to all the elements other than oxygen and hydrogen. And the elements other than oxygen and hydrogen are nitrogen, which is balanced. Its 10 atoms are present on both the sides. And other element is iodine, which is also balanced. Its 2 atoms are present on both the sides. Now, let us balance oxygen. The number of oxygen atoms on the left hand side is 30. 10 multiplied by 3. 30 atoms of oxygen are present on the left hand side, but on the right hand side, the number of oxygen atom is 10 into 2 plus 2 into 3, that is 26. But on the left hand side, there are 30 atoms of oxygen. Thus, we see that there are 4 atoms of oxygen less on the right hand side. It means the right hand side is deficient in number of oxygen atoms by 4, and therefore we must add 4 H2O molecules on the right hand side in order to balance oxygen. Now let us see, hydrogen is balanced or not. 10 atoms of hydrogen are present on the left hand side, and on the right hand side there are 2 atoms of hydrogen here and 8 atoms of hydrogen here. There are overall 10 atoms of hydrogen on the right hand side also. And therefore, this redox reaction is now completely balanced. And we have not balanced charge in this method. Charge is balanced automatically. Thank you for watching the video with patience. Please like and share it. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, please subscribe it so that you may get the information regarding my new video in time. Thank you again.